back was against the rope the entire time I was walking him down. Could have been a little bit more assertive. I was patient. I was seeing my shots, but I didn't want to be antsy. You got all the way right. He may have landed a couple times, but I know he threw a lot, missed a lot, blocked a lot, and I feel great in my conditioning. I mean, I fucking felt amazing out there, cardio-wise. My body felt good, even when he landed, you know, a hard shot. I know you're in great shape and you're in condition for it. You're able to absorb more. You hit me in the body a couple times. I'm like, nah, dog, take more than that. So I felt like I had him. One time I almost knocked him through the rope. I really wouldn't fuck with that rope. It was like we came in this morning to do a test run. It's like, if you're not 7'7", shit, you can be held up by it. So I hit him, and he kind of bent into the rope, so I was going to try to knock him through that motherfucker.
Do you feel the power, I guess, of their, you know, their camp was saying?
No. Look at my face. You look like I felt somebody's power?
No, you still look good, man.
I got hit with a shot with this boxing. I was supposed to not get hit. I have one cut on my face. I look just as pretty as I did going in, coming out. I never touched the canvas. He was the only one else was touching the canvas. Like I said before, I believe the rope actually held him up.
Keith, right here.
Did you have any confidence at all in Jimmy
Allen's
ring
the score cards? I thought I won. To be honest, I was surprised it was a split decision. I thought it was close. I thought he had won some rounds. I thought early in the rounds was close. And you know, if I can go back, I kind of kick myself because I could have made it a little bit more convincing. But I was just trying to fill him out and I was trying to take my time. And you know, I knew he was gonna throw a lot of jabs. I was just gonna see how he was gonna react to feints and pressure. And no, I wasn't surprised when they said the split. I knew it was kind of close, and I thought it was going to be me. So I was kind of more, my demeanor and my emotion was because I wanted to knock him out. And I had a couple big shots I landed, a couple opportunities, and I think I had him. I had him hurt. I had him tired a couple times, and I didn't press him a little bit. I should have pressed him a little bit more, but I was just, you know. The last fight, I had a guy on the ropes, and I fucking went ape shit on him. I was going crazy, and I got stuck with a punch. So I was just trying to be a little bit more smart.
USA Today in the back.
Tyron, do you feel like mostly you wanted to because you had the biggest moment in the fight when you pushed him back against the ropes there? And you know,
I had the biggest moment in the fight for sure, but I told you guys a long time ago, I said, don't get this shit fucked up. Everybody like, oh, this YouTuber. No, I told you, it's going to look like a fight. I said it from the very beginning. I never played like it wasn't a fight. You can see the way I was training, the way I was built, my conditioning. I knew it was going to be a fight, but I was going to be patient. I was expecting myself to get the knockout. So I definitely had the biggest moment. I felt like that's when the momentum shifted in that round. And I feel like, you know, I had the bigger punches, and I feel like I had more pressure.
Ellie, right here in
front. Ellie, you've been asking some bullshit that you haven't already seen.
No.
That motherfucker like,
one more back here.
Even if the rematch doesn't materialize next.
No, it's going to
You still want to pursue boxing though, regardless.
For sure, I'm doing a rematch, so I got to get that win. It was too close, and you know, this was a movie. Ain't nobody going to push me like me and him did. We fucking sold the shit out this pay-per-view. I think everybody was excited about it. With some humorous moments, and I couldn't even really watch a lot of it because I was trying to stay focused, but Jake, man, he good at what he do. If I would have allowed him to get into my mind, to get into my head, it could have been a similar circumstance as his previous opponent. So he was tough. He was fatigued in the fight, and he found a way to push through, and he came through strong. So I can't never knock him for that, but we got to run that back.
Tell me about the conversation. First of all, congratulations on the performance.
Yeah.
You had with Jake after where he said, if you get the tattoo, you get the rematch.
Yeah, I mean, I said, shit, fuck it, let's do it. I mean, you only live once, man. This is a movie. And this whole time, I felt like this was a real ass movie. And I'm like, dude, the promo, the fucking, all the PR behind it, all the stuff, the training, the antics, everything that went with it. I've never been a part of nothing like this again. And to even do another fight that's not on this magnitude is kind of feel weird. You know what I mean? So I want to fucking do it again. I think the next time it's going to be bigger. People see it's a real fight now. It's not like some YouTube kid fucking fighting some old ass UFC fighter that's washed up. You know, he fought a fucking man that came in there and meant business.
Did you get that tattoo already?
No, I had to take a shower. My damn shoulders are sore from knocking his head around.
Right here.
Tyron, how did the situation on Thursday affect you?
It didn't. You know, that was a separate situation. I just don't fuck around when it comes down to my mom. And I appreciate you. I saw you in the mix a little bit. You know, right is right. And that's why I just told Jay Lee on love. I said, you know, I don't really care. You can do whatever you want to. You can say whatever you want to. You could have took my hat because you can see I got a full hairline, my hair fresh. You can do whatever you want, but when you start going back and forth with my mom, you'll get scraped.
What surprised you most about him tonight?
Nothing surprised me, to be honest. I kept telling you, I said, this is going to look like a fight. I just thought I was going to be able to knock him out. And I could have had, if I would have pressured him a little bit more, I think that I would have brought that moment up. But I know he's athletic. I know he has a screw loose. His elevator will go over to the top floor. And in combat sports, he'll be the fucking toughest dude sometimes. I knew one or two shots wasn't going to hurt him to the point where he was just going to quit. I did hit him in the body a couple of times that he didn't like. You know, I wish I would have kept putting money in the bank there. But at the end of the day, I knew he was tough. I knew he was training hard. Like, this is like, if he beat me, he can give his all. Like, imagine if you got a chance to go one-on-one with Michael Jordan. You don't give a fuck. You're going to go crazy. You know what I mean? I'm not saying I'm Michael Jordan because I know y'all going to spin that and take that one line and make a whole headline out of it. But what I'm saying is that he was facing somebody who had championship belts in the toughest division in the world at the time. And he put everything into it. You know, he ain't got no kids. He ain't got no day job. You know, this all he had to do. So I expect him to come prepared. I expect him to come ready. Next time, I'm going to be even more prepared. He's going to be even more prepared. And the fight's going to be even better.
Tyron, you said nothing surprised you. Did anything impress you about Jake tonight?
No, because I was already expecting. You know, I was already expecting him. He threw a couple combinations, but you know, you gotta expect somebody that only had four fights to evolve. I didn't even look at. He don't have that many fights, to be honest. And I didn't even waste time looking back at his fights, looking at his fucking sparring, because he's smart. He's putting out all the flash, shooting money guns, and fucking hitting the folks. He's not putting real shit on the internet because he's in its infant stages of boxing. And for somebody that's, you know, got good size, good punch, good IQ, good chin, and just fucking, like I said, you know, he's just gonna give a fuck sometimes. I think, you know, you gotta be prepared for that. For me, I feel like nothing really impressed me. And that's not to say that he wasn't impressive. I just expected a lot.
You had the tattoo thing obviously came up afterwards. Is there any part of you, though, that feels like Jake rewatches a fight, maybe rewatches that right hand, maybe he doesn't want to do the rematch?
No, he already said it now. He making all these dumbass bets, and I keep forgetting I'm fighting a child, man. I'm like, I got a kid that's 18 that's about to go play D1 football, and I'm sitting here dealing with somebody that's not too much older than him, and he making all these bets, and I'm just trying to be professional, trying not to laugh. So, yeah, I think his pride's important to him, and I think part of him taking this fight was that. So him fighting me again, or committing to fighting me and not going through with it, I don't think he's going to do that.
So I'm actually not going to talk shit. I'm a YouTuber myself, and I thought they were giving it to you or a draw to get a part two to happen.
That's what I thought.
Do you regret not letting your hands go? And if there was a part two, would you not be afraid to let your hands go?
No, there is going to be a part two. And, you know, I do regret it. Was certain moments when I clipped him one time and when I saw him huffing and puffing and his hands were going. I'm not going to say the shots because I think those shots are going to come back the next time around. Mm-hmm. But I saw a couple shots that I know I could have landed. And I think I was just like, man, just don't it's there, don't rush it, because body language says a lot. Anytime you open up and show a big shot, like when he landed his right hand, it's because he didn't show it. When he showed it, he missed it, and I blocked it or anything like that. So I was just trying to get my body language not to show that I saw the opening.
Okay. We got one more question, Mark. Tyron, you get the tattoo tonight?
Shit, I don't know. I need to see some paperwork on this rematch shit, because I think that's the game plan.
Where are you gonna get it?
Are you gonna make sure that you get something in paper before you get the tattoo so that they
have the
rematch?
To be honest, Nikisi gave me his word. He hasn't did me wrong since. So I kind of got to roll with him on that. He's honored everything he said to me since the beginning with this whole promotion thing. So
where are you gonna get it?
Shit, I ain't finna get it nowhere where I gotta fucking look at that bitch. I don't know, probably my thigh or some shit.
I thought I was gonna get on my face. Ty, what's the one thing that Jake said that made you really want to laugh, but you just didn't want to lose character?
Yeah, I already know. And he was baiting me too. He was trying to get me canceled, wasn't he?
Yeah.
He was trying to get me the baby, but I didn't take the bait. I just kept saying to myself, I'm glad I wear sunglasses. Normally when you guys see me fight week, I'm wearing sunglasses because I'm sucked down. My fucking drained and my eyes, the light makes my eyes really hard to see, and I'm annoyed, and you're asking the same dumbass questions that everybody, you just heard fucking Jaws ask me, why you ask me how I feel? I feel like shit. I'm cutting 35 pounds. What do you think I feel like? So this time it was just because I wanted to just block it out. You know, I knew he was going to have these scripts and monologues and this whole fucking spiel, but then he started saying, I ain't even gonna get into it.
Yeah.
But that shit was funny.
What do you think of the Showtime promotion versus UFC?
Man, they killed that shit. Yeah. I can't say it's comparative. Like, only thing I can say is this was a complete movie. And I enjoyed it. It was a lot. It was a lot of PRs, a lot of cameras. But one thing they were always mindful of is we're still fighting. We still got to train. It was mindful of rest. It was mindful of scheduling. And that was something that I will go ahead and say that, you know, sometimes the UFC got so many fights. They got 4 or 5 fights a month. They don't give a fuck. They put that camera on you. They don't care if you're cutting weight, if you're fucking looking ashy or, you know, dying in the sauna. They want their camera time. And I do got to shout out, you know, all the 24/7, all the Showtime crew. It was like 4 or 5 different crews that was pressing. And I remember Showtime when I was a young whippersnapper coming up, but I feel like they've evolved to a whole nother level. Got a shout out to Alicia. She's a GOAT. She was cold. And she just, the way they communicated, Chris, I know he and Dory somewhere around here.
That's cool. So,
everybody, yeah, you know, because I'm not the easiest person to deal with. Sometimes I get cranky, sometimes I get annoying, but they were very professional. And I'm blessed to have fought for Showtime again. I miss it a lot. And I felt like I was treated with respect. And I look forward to doing it again.
What did Pedro, GT, and Eric tell you after the fight?
They told me they thought I won. They said it was a close fight, but I think you won. You landed the power shots. Motherfucker, act like you won. That doesn't mean you know you won. Don't be sitting around. I was kind of sad because I wanted to knock him out because he was talking all that shit. And I was like, I know I could have knocked him out. And I knew if I rushed, you know, look what happened to Nate Robinson when he rushed. Look what happened when Ben didn't have his hands up. And I didn't even see the other fights, but, you know, he pried on people, like, rushing in and letting their emotions get to him. And I think I need to find a happy medium. So I was more bummed about that, but I still thought I wanted to fight, you know. So they, of course, my coaches are world-class. They all three of them in their own right. And they all three, you know, say, hey, we're going to go back and look at the film. We're going to figure out what we need to do. We're going to keep growing. You were in shape, you know. We know what we could have did better. I felt like you won the fight. And, you know, they're not going to tell me they thought I lost the fight if I lost. They're not going to tell me that they thought I won the fight, you know what I mean, if they didn't think I won the fight. So I feel good about it. I feel good about my performance. I feel good that any motherfucker that thought I was old and thought I was washed up and thought I wasn't going to back up and just defend, the motherfuckers know now.
All right, guys, thank you very much.
Thanks, Ty.